Base excision repair. The process of base excision repair is responsible for recognizing and removing damaged bases from the genome that could otherwise cause harmful mutations by mispairing of bases during DNA replication. Base excision repair is facilitated by the help of various enzymes. DNA glycosylase is one example. Glycosylases are lesion-specific enzymes, and cells have multiple types of DNA glycosylases with different specialties. A total of 11 different DNA glycosylases have been identified within human cells. When looking at DNA, oxidation of guanine is one of the most common types of damage that can occur. This results from DNA's interaction with reactive oxygen species, potentially resulting from something such as exposure to ionizing radiation. This causes the formation of oxoguanine, and consequently results in lesions on the DNA strand and a mismatched base pair. To fix this, the OxoG glycosylase enzyme binds to the DNA strand, scanning along the strand looking for damage. Once it finds and recognizes a damaged base, the OxoG glycosylase flips the damaged base out of the double helix and into its specificity pocket. It then proceeds to cleave the glycosidic bond of the damaged base, leaving behind an AP site. Next, an AP endonuclease enzyme cuts the DNA backbone at the 5' position of the AP site, leaving behind a 3' OH group. Following this, an exonuclease enzyme cuts at the 3' position of the AP site, leaving behind a 5' phosphate group. DNA polymerase 1 comes in and fills the resulting gap, and continues repair synthesis by inserting the correct base using the undamaged strand as a template. Finally, DNA ligase seals the 5' end of the gap with the help of ATP. This completes the process of base excision repair. But what happens if the damaged base isn't removed for the process of base excision repair before DNA replication is to occur? The cell has an additional line of defense. Special enzymes known as fail-safe glycosylases can help out in this situation. The fail-safe glycosylase recognizes an adenine paired with an oxoguanine as a mutation that shouldn't be there. To resolve this, the oxo-G stays in place, and the undamaged base is removed by the fail-safe glycosylase to be replaced with a cytosine. Both of these mechanisms help to decrease the mutation rate before DNA replication takes place.